Hi, my name is Colt Correa. I'm the COO of Intrepid Control Systems, and I'm here to talk about software-defined vehicles and the tools needed to develop those. So what we're seeing in the industry is a big push towards software-defined vehicles. Most people that are in the industry know this already, but what does it mean when we look under the hood as far as the electronic changes that are happening to support that? And what the industry is going through is a transformation towards a new type of architecture around the electronic control units in the vehicle, away from traditional, what we call domain-based architectures, towards a zonal architecture. In a domain-based architecture, you have a lot of different ECUs that perform specific functions in the vehicle. And in a zonal architecture, we try to combine as many ECUs as possible into a centralized superbrain. And the superbrain then would make most of the decisions for the vehicle. But a consequence of that is that the superbrain, the central processing unit, will make most of the decisions, but the actuators and sensors around the vehicles need to stay where they're at, like a brake actuator or wheel speed sensors, these kind of things. What that means is that most of the control of these actuators and sensors in the future will be remotely controlled over a network. And this brings in the importance of, for a zonal architecture or SDV vehicles, the importance of the network itself. And so we're seeing lots of network changes in the vehicle, moving away from traditional networks like CAN-FD, FlexRay, towards more automotive Ethernet. So we definitely will see in the industry automotive Ethernet becoming more and more important. And Intrepid Control Systems, we have a wide variety of different tools to support this new architecture, and specifically automotive Ethernet. For example, we have a RAD-Galaxy 2 that supports 16 ports of 1000 base T1 or configurable to 100 base T1 as well. We have RAD-Epsilon family of switches with a wide variety of different ports and features as well. RAD-Comet is designed specifically for the new network 10 base T1S, which is a bus-based automotive Ethernet architecture. We have support for 6 10 base T1S ports on this, as well as CAN legacy networks. We have a full suite of media converters, RAD-Moon from 100 megabit T1 all the way up to multi-gig T1. RAD-Gigastar is a configurable tap with SFP cages. We have 2 ports of 1000 base T1 or 100 base T1. We have SFP cages where customers can swap out which networks they want to use. And we also have these tools being used as data loggers in vehicles as well. So we have other tools that can upload data to the cloud remotely, and the whole suite is around the new paradigm of software-defined vehicles.